Trevor, look at you. This is great. Welcome along to the Mulgrave Country Club. It is over the other side of town. I know Essendon's all the way over there, but you lovely people have made the effort to come and see us here tonight. Well done. Thank you very much. It's really good to see you. The boys out the back are very happy that you're here as well, so they'll be out to say, give their appreciation very shortly. Let's get on with the show. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Welcome to That's Good for Footy. We're the only live and interactive footy panel show going around in Australia. This is where the fans meet the players and the players meet the fans. That's what we do here. You're going to see them in a different light tonight. That's what we want to do. So, please welcome to the show our first panellist. He was born on the 25th of July 1997. He's played a total of 95 games and kicked a total of 38 goals. Yeah? Giving away any hints yet? Any hints? Yeah. He made his AFL debut back in 2016. When he plays for the Essendon Football Club, he wears a number... Three on his back. There we go. Could you please welcome to the stage, Darcy Parrish.
Sing along the squire, to win the premiership of flag.
There he is.
Our boys who play this grand old game are always striving for glory and fame.
All right. You've got another one coming. I love that sound, though. That was bloody good. Nice little welcome, isn't it?
Yeah, bloody fantastic. Don't give Pigeon that much.
Yeah, well done. I like it. All right, let's get our second panellist out here. He was born on the 2nd of June 1998. I won't stop halfway in between here. He's played a total of 80 games and kicked 16 goals. He made his AFL debut back in 2017. When he plays for the Essendon Football Club, he wears a number one on his back. Could you please welcome to the stage Andrew McGrath. Getting involved in that. Apart from that table over there, you can go now. No, it was wonderful. You were all fantastic. Great to actually hear that because it's probably the first time you've heard it this year. I don't mean to be derogatory, but it's bloody nice to hear it. I'm just saying. It's good to hear it. It's fantastic. And you gave a great rendition. What do you care? It's great. You got it out of your system. Nice to have you here. Let's get involved. Andrew, how are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, very well. Good. Yep.
It's good to hear some Bomber fans. We didn't hear too many on the weekend. There was a lot of Port Adelaide people over there, but it's nice to hear.
Yeah. Well, you're amongst people that love you here tonight. And
it feels great. It feels really good.
That, it'll make you feel wonderful. What we want to do is we want to get to know the players a little bit better, and what we're going to do, we're going to introduce it in a segment called What's Going On.
What's going on?
I love it. Every time that I do these shows, I have the players come up and they're obviously all in their 20s or thereabouts, and those songs come on and they just go, oh, what? I got no idea. So that was Marvin Gaye, boys, just for your benefit. I want to talk about pre-season. I want to talk about the last two rounds and obviously heading into round three. So we'll get stuck into it, boys. You go down to the Hawks by one in round one, and then you travel across the border to Adelaide to get beaten by a really good Port side on their home deck, no less. Not an ideal situation to be in. But then to add to the woes, you've got Heppel withdraws with a back spasm, Shill injures his knee, Caldwell does a hammy, Draper does an ankle, plus your went-in missing Stringer, Ambrose, Hurley, Zarkarakis, Guelphy, Stewart, just to name a few. Wow. That's a fair bit going on, isn't it, boys? How are you getting your heads around everything that's happening at the club at the moment in order to move into round three with some positivity?
Yeah,
who wants to answer that, he said?
Yeah, like you said, it's been a challenging couple of weeks. We started the season pretty well, the first half against Hawthorn, and then from there we probably haven't been at the level, both competitively and then with the injuries too on the weekend. It was difficult. Port Adelaide are a great side. I think even if we played our best throughout the whole game, they still probably would have got us over there. But the Hawthorn one was very disappointing. And to lose, like I said before, three key guys, it's going to be difficult, but we're a system-based football club right now. Guys are going to have to step up. You're going to see younger guys playing bigger roles. Their development's going to get fast-tracked, and regardless of what's going on with the football club in terms of injuries, we come out every week to try and win, and that's no different this week.
Absolutely. Listen, it's very hard to talk about it off the top because I don't like talking about the negativity, but I just want to get the elephant in the room out of the way so as we can get back to being normal. You just alluded to the fact, now I know this makes way for new talent to emerge, but I know it's always going to be hard under these circumstances. I'm not trying to make excuses for you, but let's be realistic. There's the adjustment being around round two, that the quarters have gone back to 20 minutes and you've obviously got rotations capped at 75 down from 90 last year. Those things are going to impact you, but then when you are playing Port Adelaide on their home deck and you're up against it, let's be realistic, as I said. I want to get this out of the way, but in relation to where you see you guys being able to get back up on top, you've got to emerge with some new talent coming in. Give us some names that you think are going to be able to help you and step up to the mark.
Yeah, I guess we went to the draft last year and got some really top-end talent from the draft. We've already seen a little bit of young Coxie out on the wing, and I think his limitations is really sky high, and he could be anything for us. We've got another bloke, Perkins, who he might be playing pretty soon, I think. He's a bit of an X-factor for us. So we've got a lot of young blokes like that, and I guess seeing Drapes go down is pretty disappointing, Calder's as well, but that's a great opportunity for other blokes to step up. We've got another ruckman, Nick Bryan, so who knows if he makes his debut or not, but there's definitely a lot of talent, young talent down there, and try and get as many games into them as we can, and fast track their development.
For sure. What's the mood like around the club? What's it been like? I know it's only Wednesday, but what's it been like since you came back from your Adelaide trip and now around the club leading into round three?
Oh, I guess there's always disappointment when you lose. We feel it just as much as you guys. It hurts and stings for a while. The Hawthorn one probably more so than the Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, like I said before, a great, well-oiled team. And the Hawthorn game, you probably should win that. But by this time of the week, we're sort of forward-thinking. We're thinking about St Kilda now. We've learnt a lot from both our losses, and hopefully we can implement some stuff that we've been working on during the week. But the mood around the group's great. I think we're all optimistic about where we're heading. We're realistic that we're a very young side, but like I said before, that doesn't put any limitations on us. No. We want to win as many games as we can, and more often than not, winning is our objective every week.
Yeah, absolutely. I just wanted to ask, who's actually impressed you over the pre-season and leading into rounds one and two? Who's kind of stood out on the track for you? Somebody that the fans may not be necessarily familiar with. Is there somebody that springs to mind?
Oh, I was going to say Drapes and Calder's, but it's pretty disappointing, obviously. But they were setting the tone for us early days. Yeah. But I think we've had a couple blokes change positions as well, and so they're learning new crafts and I guess a new style of their play. And I think Jaden Laverty's been super impressive for us down back. Young Neddy Carl as well, although his probably form hasn't been like he'd like, but it's a new role for him and he's learning every day. So, but probably Doss for me.
I've loved seeing Dyson down back. That's been a real instrumental change. How's he coping with that? I know he had the back spasms on the weekend, but that's a new role for him. How's he?
Yeah, really good. It's just been great to have Dyson out in the park. We've missed him for so long, and his body's sort of very bruised and battered at the moment, and it was a real shame to see him go down during the week in a pretty innocuous incident. But just having Dyson on the field makes a huge difference for our football club, and
absolutely.
I think his composure and his knowledge back there has really helped our young back line. And in terms of guys that have impressed me, there's been a lot. I think Das and Zachy Merritt have set the tone in the midfield. And then the same guys that Das has mentioned. Jaden moving to halfback has been great. Young Nettie, who lives with me, has been really good. I think he's going to be a player for the future. And then Jordan Ridley, our BNF winner last year, just picked up where he left off.
Yeah, great. I have put down here, like a horse racing tip, is there anybody that, if you had to suggest, we have to keep an eye out in 2021, who's going to be a standout at the Essendon Football Club, in your opinion?
I think I touched on him before. Coxie, I think he can be an absolute star in the making.
Yeah.
He's a freak runner, freak athlete, can kick both sides of his body, super in tight, and it's unreal to watch him at training. And I think Perkins is another one, just games under his belt. He'll get more and more confident each week, and I think, he could do anything.
Good.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with both those two. And then I'll probably throw in Zach Reid as well. He's a little bit more underdeveloped than the other two, but he moves and sort of plays a bit like Harris Andrews, but I think it'll take him a couple of years to get there. But he's one I'm really looking forward to playing with.
Good, excellent. All right. See, there's some positivity coming out of this. I'm turning over the grey cloud and turning it into a white one. All right, so here we go. We're talking about round three. This will test your depth, obviously. You're sitting 17th at 0-2. You're coming up against the Saints at 4:35pm at Marvel Stadium on Saturday afternoon. They're coming off their loss to the D's, so they're going to be smarting. We all know fast starts are the key to the new brand of football, the fast-flowing football that the AFL is trying to introduce, obviously with the standing on the mark rules, stay still. I wanted to find out what they're trying to create and how you guys are going to come up against the Saints, who are really good at fast starts, in the AAMI Community Series against Carlton. 22 goals kicked in that first half. They came out last weekend against the D's. It was quite a strong start for them again, even though the D's were on top. How are you guys going to negate that? What's the focus around the club at the moment about beating them to the ball and being hard and tougher than them?
Yeah, I suppose probably our last couple of games we haven't started the way we would like, but I think this week we've got to be ready for the fight and be up for it, and we want to be in there playing our style from the start, and I think consistently throughout the whole game. You see in the Hawthorn game that third quarter let us down and probably cost us the game in the end, and I think consistency for us is a big thing, and just trying to compete hard and just show effort all night, which will be really important.
The last thing I've got here, Saints have got some exceptional on-ballers, so you're going to have to be at your best to nullify their run and carry and spread. Ultimately, though, how do you see this game being played out?
I think you touched on it. I think it's won and lost in the contest. We have spoken a lot about it over the last couple of weeks. Port Adelaide sort of took us to the cleaners in there around the midfield, and St Kilda are another good midfield unit, so we'll take a lot of ownership in that this week, Darce and I in there with Zaki as well, and I think the game will be won and lost in there. So if we can get the ball moving forward more often than not, that'll go a long way in winning the game.
Max King's been a great addition to the St Kilda Football Club. Who's going to come up against him?
Yeah, good question. We haven't done too much of our Oppo analysis yet. That's more tomorrow. But
okay.
I feel like it'll be Ridley or Francis.
Okay.
My opinion.
Yeah, well, it's going to be a hard one because, as I said, they're coming off smarting off their loss to the D's last weekend. This is your chance to come out there. Marvel Stadium, of course. It'd be great to see, a really good crowd get along because you're both talking Essendon versus St Kilda at Marvel Stadium. 4:35 on a Saturday afternoon, you probably can't get much better than that. Roof will be closed. I understand the AFL have come out and said the roof will be closed for all the Etihad games for the rest of the season. What are your thoughts on that? That will be a question later, but what do you think now?
I think during the day it has to be shut. Like that sun is, it's a pain to play in. I've done it a couple of times and it's pretty hard to play. But I guess it's just a level playing field.
Yeah.
If the roof's shut, you know what you're going to expect going to that ground, and you just got to go with it.
You pumped, excited?
Can't wait.
Bring it on.
I think the first game we played at Etihad or Marvel now with our fans back was amazing. Just brought a real vibe and energy to it, and we can't wait to get back out there in front of hopefully a predominantly Essendon crowd. Other than last week was a bit different, but can't wait to get out and play in front of you guys again. It was awesome.
Excellent. Well, that's it. That's all I wanted to do. I wanted to find out about what's going to be happening in round three, how they've been dealing with round one and two, who to look out for, and who's going to come out eventual winners on the weekend. It's going to be Essendon, yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Well, there you go. Please put your hands together for the boys. I'm going to introduce a segment. It's called Simply the Best. You're simply the best. I know this song, Sam, so that's great. That's fantastic. So what's going to happen here, boys? As I said, we've got Nicholas down the front. Andrew's going to be keeping score for you, Nicholas.
Yep.
And Lockie, Darcy's going to be keeping score for you.
Yeah.
All right? So as soon as I ask the question, you'll hear this tick, tick, tick noise, and if you don't get the question in time all right, you'll hear the and we'll move on. All right. You ready to go, boys?
Yes.
Yes? Yes. All right.
Yes.
Here's your first question. Which Essendon player has played the most games in the history of the club? Hang on until I give you the three answers. Is it A, Simon Madden, B, Dick Reynolds, or C, Dustin Fletcher?
Lockie?
C, Dustin Fletcher.
It is correct. Well done, mate, with 400. Beautiful. Off to a flyer. How many VFL, AFL grand finals has the Essendon Football Club played in?
Lockie. I'm going to go with... 22.
Tick, Did you say 22?
22.
No, you'd be wrong. Nicholas, do you want to have a go? I think... Quick, Nicholas.
26.
26 is incorrect. It was 29. Bad luck, boys. Who is your team's captain?
Oh. Nicholas.
Nicholas.
Darcy Happel.
Correct. Well done. Out of these three players, and wait until I finish the entire question, out of these three players, who has captained the Essendon Football Club the most? Is it A, Dyson Heppel, B, Job Watson, or C, Mark Thompson?
Nicholas.
Nicholas.
Job Watson.
Correct. Well done. Essendon has been minor premiership winners in the club's history a total of A, 15 times, B, 17 times, or C, 21 times?
Lockie.
Lockie.
I'm going to go B, 17 times.
You'd be correct, mate. Well done. Beautiful. Where did Essendon Where did Essendon finish at the end of the home and away season last year?
Lockie.
Lockie.
12.
No. Nicholas.
13th.
Correct. Well done. Who wears the number 7 at the Essendon Football Club?
Lockie. Zach Merritt.
Correct, mate. Well done. This is for 2 points, boys. Player and goals. Who was your club's leading goal kicker in 2018 and how many goals did they kick?
Lockie. Anthony McDonald and Woody.
Very good, mate. And goals?
I'm going to say, I want to say like 27, something like that.
How many?
27.
No. You've got half of it. Nicholas, do you want to have a guess?
I think 30.
Did you say 30?
Yes.
No, it was 19. So you get 1 point there, Lockie. How many games did your team win last year at the end of the home and away season?
Lockie. I'm going to go 7.
No. Nicholas.
Nicholas. I think...
Have a guess, buddy.
9.
9? No, it was 6. Bad luck, boys. Name 3 coaches over the last 20 years.
Lockie. Nicholas.
Lockie.
James Heard, Mark Thompson and Ben Rutten.
Yeah, beautiful, mate. Well done. All right. How many losing grand finals has the Essendon Football Club played in?
Nicholas.
Nicholas.
29.
No.
Lockie, 13.
Oh, so close. 15, mate. Bad luck. All right. Closest to within 1,000, how many members does your club currently have?
Lockie.
Lockie.
I'm going to go 72,000.
72?
Yeah.
Right. No, that would be wrong. Nicholas. Have a guess, buddy.
66.
Wow. 66,686. Oh, yeah. Well done. Oh. Not bad. Well done. All right. Out of these 3 Essendon Grand Finals, which had the largest crowd in attendance? Was it A, 1993 versus Carlton? Was it 1965 versus St Kilda as B? Or was it C, 1985 versus Melbourne?
Nicholas.
Nicholas.
A?
No, mate. Lockie, do you want to have a go, buddy?
I'll go C. It's a bit hard. I haven't even been alive for a finals win yet, so...
So do you...
Yeah, I'll go C.
You'll go C?
Yeah,
bad
C.
Luck, boys. You're both wrong. It was B, 1965 versus St Kilda. 104,846 people. Huge crowd. How many premierships has the Essendon Football Club won?
Lockie. It was Nick.
What was it, Lockie?
It was Nick. Nick got it first. Nick got it first.
You do it.
Yeah?
No, it was you.
What was his answer?
I actually missed it. It's 16, I'm pretty sure, if I'm not mistaken, but it's probably going to be 15.
It's wrong. Nicholas?
I'm actually wrong. 17?
No,
14. Bad luck. Which out of these 3 players has won the most BNFs at the Essendon Football Club? Is it A, Job Watson, B, James Heard, or C, Simon Madden? Nicholas?
James Heard.
Correct. How are we going here score-wise, boys? 5 versus 5. All right. All right. Here we go. This is for 3 points, boys. Player, year and votes is what I'm after. How many votes in what year and who was the last Essendon player to win the Brownlow Medal?
Lockie. Nicholas.
Oh, Lockie.
I'm going to go with Job Watson, but I don't know if you're going to count that or not. So I'm going to say Job Watson. He won it in 2012 and he got 29 votes.
He did. That's a tricky
James
one.
James Heard.
I'm going to give it to you. Right, but then we're going to go with your answer as well, Nicholas.
How many points?
James.
Three.
James Hood.
Yes.
Points.
What year, buddy?
Year and points. 22 points. No. Points, I mean?
No. 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 James Hood, 1996. 21 votes.
21.
All right. Oh, and, and for 1 point, can either of you tell me who he tied that year with?
Lockie. Lockie? He tied with... Oh, he tied with Voss. Voss and I think... oh, who was the other guy? I'm going to go with Simon Black, but he didn't even play back then, I reckon.
I don't even know what he's saying. So was that Michael Voss?
Michael Voss. Yeah. Michael Voss, yeah.
There you go. All right. How many Brownlow medalists has the Essendon Football Club produced in its history? Is it A, 6, B, 10, C, 8?
Nicholas. 8.
Oh, well done. Beautiful. I didn't mean to sound surprised then. I just thought that was a good answer. Well done. All right, 7 versus 9. Nicholas, you need to come back here if you're to take away the big prize. What year did your team last win a grand final?
Nicholas.
Who did they play? Nicholas.
2000, Melbourne.
That'll do. You don't have to say any more. 2000 in Melbourne. You get it. Actually, that one was just worth one. I do apologise. That was worth one. So it's 8 versus 9. How many points did you win that grand final by?
Nicholas.
Nicholas. Take it. Quick.
18.
No. What do you think, Lockie?
They got absolutely smashed. Melbourne did.
Yeah.
It's 69, I've heard from the crowd. So
did you say 59?
69.
69.
Yeah.
No, it was 60. Bad luck. All right, so what'll be on 9 versus 8? All right, don't be a tiebreaker. Don't be a tiebreaker. What year and who was the last Essendon player to win the Norm Smith medal?
Lockie. It would be James Hurd.
There you go. We have a winner, ladies and gentlemen. We absolutely have a winner. Well done. Good on you, champ. Well done, brother. That was great. That was so cool. As a runner-up prize, Nicholas, you've got that. All right. Congratulations. And for you, if you'd just like to go around underneath this chair, stand underneath that chair there, that's a pair of...
Oh, noise
cancelling
headphones.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So congratulations. That was great. Well done, Lockie. Well done, Nicholas. Thanks for coming up and participating. This segment is called You Took the Words Right Out of My Mouth. Fantastic. We got Josh and David up the front here. Josh, you're going to be keeping score for Andrew McGrath, okay? And David, you're going to be keeping score for Darcy Parrish, all right? So what's going to happen here, boys, is I'm going to give you an actual movie. A movie title. We've got two great sponsors involved this year, Big Picture People and Yamaha. Because of their businesses and what they run, they look after home theatres and surround sound, and obviously movies has a good synergy with that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you, I'm actually going to give you the line from a famous movie. I then want you to tell me what movie it's from and then who the actor was. Not in the movie, but just the real life actor. All right? Are you ready to go, boys? You don't look like you are. You got your microphones... I don't know, Damo. Let's see how you go, boys. It's all right. All you've got to do is use your name or a buzzer as your identification. So would you like to test your buzzer, Andrew, please?
Beep.
Okay.
Darcy.
Darcy, you can go with Darcy. That'll work. All right. So here comes your first one. Everybody each week tells me, Damo, you got to play the part. All right, so I'm going to try and get into it. So here we go. Here's the first movie. Here's the line. You can't handle the truth. What movie? Shh. No answers from the audience. Shh. You can't handle the truth. Nothing?
No idea.
No idea? Neither?
Nah.
What about you two down the front? You guys got any idea?
Help us out, Dave.
Is my acting that bad? Is my voice that bad? And what about from the audience? Few Good Men. And the actor? Yeah, well done. All right. You get a point, but you don't get anything else. Well done. All right. I feel the need for speed.
Darcy.
Yes, Darcy.
Fast and Furious?
No. 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 They're laughing because they like the answer, not laughing for any other reason.
I would have guessed the same thing. I have no idea.
I feel the need for speed. Give you a hint. It was got supersonic planes in it.
Come to me.
Yeah.
Top Gun.
Yes. Excellent. Excellent. Beautiful. Do you know who the actor was?
Tom Cruise.
Sandy, keep an eye on these people. There's lip reading stuff going on. Well done. So we got 1 point down the front there for Darcy. All right, David. Thank you very much. That's not a knife. This is a knife.
Darcy.
Yes, Darcy.
Crocodile Dundee.
Yes.
What's his...
You're asking the wrong bloke.
I'll give Pidgey a go. What's the actor?
I have no idea.
I don't know the actor.
Famous Australian. Used to have a thing where he'd say, throw another shrimp on the barbie.
Hogan?
Yes. Yeah, well done. Awesome. Very good, isn't
Blind
it?
You.
All right. Okay. Here we go. Wilson!
Castaway.
Hey! Castaway. The actor?
I can see him.
Yeah. Came to Australia, was involved in COVID when he first got here.
He's blind. I forget his name. I don't know his name.
No?
No.
No? Gone?
No.
Tom Hanks. All right. 1 point, though, Josh. 1 point. We'll give you that. That was good. All right.
Take one.
Are you ready? I see dead people.
Yeah, when was the movie released?
How do I do this? An actor that's normally in action movies was an actor in this movie.
That's not helping.
Yeah, no good. So I got no idea.
No idea?
Nah.
It's Sixth Sense, Bruce Willis. No good. All right. Okay. All right. No. Let's try something a little bit more.
Yep.
I don't know. To infinity and beyond.
Superman.
Buzz Lightyear.
Oh yeah.
What?
Yeah. That's what he says, mate. Yeah. In what's the movie?
Which movie was it?
Well, I'm answering it.
What do you reckon?
What?
You've got Buzz...
Stop making me laugh. You're distracting me.
You've got Buzz Lightyear. Is that correct?
Yeah.
That's what you've said so far, but you have to give me the movie.
Toy Story. Oh.
Yes! All right. Well done. Excellent. Here we go. It's very entertaining.
What are we on?
All right. I'm king of the world! Think of... a season going really bad and it's a sinking ship kind of thing.
Titanic?
Yes! Titanic. Yeah, right? Excellent. And who would the actor be? You won't know.
What the name?
No good?
No, I'll pass to Dallas.
Pass.
No? Leonardo DiCaprio? Thank you, Josh. Well done. Take a point for that. Well done.
Love that.
All right, what have we got down there score-wise, if you guys are still awake? 3-4?
2-4.
Fantastic. All right. All right. Let's see how we go then. Got a couple more for you. They may take our lives, but they will never take our freedom. Have to have seen this movie, boys. Australian actor. blue and white on his face.
Captain America.
Another hint.
Another hint, please. No, that was good, man. That was good.
So it was actually
Mel Gibson in Braveheart.
Okay. Oh, Braveheart.
Yeah, not ringing any bells. Have you guys seen Braveheart or?
No.
No. Oh, okay. No. All right. All right. Try this one. Andrew's accusing me of looking at the answers. He's still not getting them right, though. Here we go. I have a certain set of skills. I will find you, and I will kill you.
Taken. Taken.
Yes, Taken. Yeah. And actor?
I know this guy.
Again, recently in Australia?
Liam Neeson, thank
yeah.
you.
All right. Josh, another point, mate. Well done. All right. Father to a murdered son, husband to a murdered wife, and I will take revenge upon those that seek me. Huge movie. Another Australian actor. His father just passed away today. Sorry about that. Rest in peace for your loss. No? No good? Russell Crowe, Gladiator. All right, there we go. All right, something probably a little bit easier. Wax on, wax off.
Karate Kid.
Yes.
I'm terrible with the names. No.
The actor's too hard. Yeah. Pat Morita. Yeah. And we'll do score-wise, boys, if I could. Six versus three. All right, well, we'll just do one more then. The first rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club. The movie would be?
Fight Club.
Fight Club, yes, beautiful. And the actor would be?
David.
David, David, yes. He likes to think of himself as a David too. No, his name is Brad Pitt. One last one, because we're having a little bit of fun here. You've got to know this one, I'm sure. If you build it, they will come.
No? Noah's Ark?
No? No good? No? Wow. That was Kevin Costner in Field of Dreams. Let's put them out of their misery. Yamaha's screaming at me through my earpiece going, don't ever do that segment again, Damo. Well done. What have we got? A score of 6-4. Hey, we have a winner. Congratulations. Josh, you're our winner. Andrew McGrath stepped up to the plate for you. David, bad luck. You're a runner-up. That doesn't mean that you go away empty-handed. That's going to be yours. All right? Congratulations. That's for you.
Oh, yeah.
And you've won the Buffalo Sports Bag, which is right there, yeah. The whole thing. Everything that's in it. All inclusive. He's going to check it. Good. Yeah. Yeah. Nice. Nice. let's introduce the segment without too much further ado. It is called Say My Name. All right, boys, the way this segment works, this is going to be 45 seconds on the clock. You've been nominated to go first, Andrew. I'm going to be reading out from the Essendon Football Club players' numbers, current list, OK? I'm going to read out the player number. You've got to give me their Christian name and their surname in 45 seconds. Each one that you get right, playing on your behalf down the front will be Scotty. Scotty's going to be flipping it over every time he hears this noise. There you go. So you got 45 seconds on the clock. To give me as many as you can.
Current players?
Current players, okay. All current players. Yeah, wouldn't do anything from 1956 or anything. Not after what we've just been through. So what's going to happen is I'll flip over, I'll be reading out the numbers, mm-hmm. and Scotty's going to flip over the scorecard. 45 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now. Number 36.
Lockie Johnson.
Correct. Number 25.
Jake Stringer.
Correct. Number 22. Pass if you don't know.
Pass.
Irving Mosquito. Number 33.
Braden Ham.
Correct. Number 12.
Tom Cutler.
Correct. Number 43.
Anthony McDonald, Tim Woody.
Beautiful. Number 7.
Zach Merritt.
Correct. Number 4.
Kyle Langford.
Correct. Number 5.
Devin Smith.
Correct. Number 6.
Jai Caldwell.
Correct. Number 1.
Andrew McGrath.
Correct. Number 30.
Brandon Zerk Thatcher.
Perfect. Number 34.
Andrew Phillips.
Correct. Number 10.
Aaron Francis.
Correct. 35.
Matt Guelfi.
Correct. 11.
David Zaharakis.
Correct. 38. I'll give you this.
Cody Brand.
Well, all right. Well done. How'd you go, Scotty? 15. All right. That's a good score, man. 15. Forgot the Moz. Wow. Put the Moz on you. There you go. 15's a very good score, though, mate. You should be very proud of yourself. Thanks for keeping score down there, Scotty. Janine, you ready to go? All right. Same thing's going to happen for you, Darcy. 45 seconds on the clock. Your time will start with your first one.
Yep.
And Janine will be keeping score. Here we go. Time starts now. Number 20.
Peter Ott.
Yeah, excellent. Number 2.
Sam Draper.
Correct. 23.
Harry Jones.
Correct. Number 9.
Dylan Shield.
Correct. 24.
Nick Bryan.
Correct. 18. 18.
Mick Hurley.
Correct. 3.
Darcy Parrish.
Correct. 26.
Cal Hooker.
Correct. 14.
Jordan Ridley.
Correct. 27.
Mason Redmond.
Correct. 17.
James Stewart.
Correct. 13.
Nick Cox.
Correct. 21.
Dyson Heppel.
Correct. 28.
Ned Carr.
Correct. 15.
Jaden Laverty.
Correct. 29.
29.
Yes.
Pat Ambrose.
Correct. 31.
Reed.
Zach Reed, were you going to say? Yes. Yeah. Janine, how'd he go?
You mean that one?
Yes.
17.
Whoa! There you go. Very good. Not bad, not bad at all. Yeah. Hey, Janine's impressed as well. That was good. That was good. We don't like to have any winners and losers at That's Good Footy, so you're both going to take home a merchandise back. There's yours. Thank you, Janine. Oh, thank you very much. And there's yours. Scotty, well done.
Thanks.
Thank you. Hey. High fist all around. I love that segment. I really love that segment. For you guys, what do? You picture it go around the locker? Is it what's your mental recall?
Oh, it's actually a lot harder than a lot of the numbers change from year to year. So you think of old guys that used to be there. So you have to sort of filter through three or four guys. But and then saying their full name's also challenging. We never called. Das was just saying he doesn't know Zach Reed's first name.
It's just been Reedy,
which is great. He's only been around for 6 months, but. Yeah, it was harder than I thought it'd be.
Yeah, I love it. I think it's fantastic. I love the recall. I love how you can quickly surmise it and get it out. And considering that you've got 45 seconds on the clock, you're under pressure. 15 versus 17, that's a good result. So well done, boys. I like it. I like it a lot. All right. Now you can just sit back and relax a little bit. There's no contestants anymore, all right? All you boys have to do is just be yourselves. But you will have to participate in these particular questions. This is a segment called What Can I Say? All right, so what I'm going to do here, boys, I'm going to ask you a series of questions. I just want you to fill in the blank. That's all you've got to do. So feel free to give us whatever props into your mind and be as free, as liberal as you like. Which one of these things gets you pumped the most before a game? Is it the smell of deep heat, the smell of fresh-cut grass, pulling on the jumper, strapping on the boots, a footy in your hands, or the sound of the crowd?
I think the sound of the crowd, probably. But I love the smell of deep heat as well. That's awesome.
Good answer, I like it.
Okay, I'm not a sicko. I don't love the smell of DV. But the sound of the crowd, definitely.
Yeah, good. All right, wonderful. Who is the most manicured down at the club? Remember, feel free, boys.
David Zaharakis.
Ah, yeah.
And we'll let you know about it too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay. Who do you think does?
I reckon Jaden Laverty. Probably every week.
Yeah, all right, cool. Do you miss running through the banners at the moment?
Yeah, I do.
Yep.
Okay, good.
Really do.
It always makes the cheer squads happy when they hear that answer. The siren is gone. You need a goal to win. Who do you hope has got the ball in their hands to win the game?
Waller. Hands down.
Yeah. Waller, hands down.
Easy.
Same?
Easily, yep.
Yeah, cool. What are your thoughts on Thursday night football?
Love it.
Love it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice. Yep, either. Bad. Yep. Essendon supporters are?
Amazing.
Amazing.
The best.
The best. All right. Well done. Which AFL club do you like to beat the most?
Collingwood.
Yeah! Good.
I don't know.
Maybe Carlton.
Yeah. It's where you win over the fans here, mate. It's really, it's quite easy to do this. Do you prefer a day or a twilight grand final?
Day for me.
Yep.
Day.
Day, good. All right.
Yep.
If you were to describe yourself as a car, what sort of a car would you be?
Well, nothing too fast, I don't think. Just durable. So I don't know. Whatever. Yeah. Whatever's durable.
Okay. What kind of answer is that, mate? Say a car.
I don't know cars.
Four by four? Are you off-road? Are you...
I think it's a ute. That's a bit ute.
Yeah. Probably.
Hardworking.
Ah, there we go.
Not too flashy.
Yeah. Doesn't mind getting dirty.
Just get it done.
Yeah, yep. Get it done. Yeah, good. Yep. All right. Who's the funniest bloke down at the club?
I'd say Nettie Carr, my little housemate.
Oh, yeah. He's really funny. Or James Stewart as well.
Okay.
When you get him going. Yeah. Hilarious.
All right. Good. Milk or Milo first?
Milk.
Milk?
I don't really have Milo, so
no?
I don't really know. No.
Oh, you've never had it?
Nah.
Okay, what about sausage in a water? Sausage in?
Nah.
No.
I'm not, I don't eat chocolate. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Mm. Oh, Easter must be a shit time for you.
Yeah, no, it is. Not great.
It's sad.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. All right. All right. No Easter eggs, all right? He doesn't eat chocolate. That's no good. All right. Because someone brought you some Easter eggs tonight and they wanted to present them to you.
I'll take them.
They can later on. Darcy said he'll look after it for you. Well, that's good. I love it when a mate steps up. That's fabulous. All right. Hey, being an AFL footballer is?
Living the dream.
Yep.
Yeah, that was the first thing. Yeah, the dream.
Good. Yep. Who's a bit tight with their money down at the club?
The skipper. He's got plenty of it too, so.
I'll say Sheely.
Yeah.
Again, plenty of it, but
really?
you don't see him shouting too much.
All right. Do you prefer any ad roof opened or closed? You said before, so we can go with that. In your opinion, who down at the club has got the most swagger?
Swagger. Chris Johnson. Oh, no. Yeah. Jono, yeah, he would.
I'll say Ned again.
Yeah?
Ned's not bad.
Okay, yep. All right. What is your favourite ground to play on around Australia apart from the MCG?
Adelaide Oval.
Yeah, I'll agree with that. Adelaide Oval's pretty cool.
Yeah, good. Okay. Playing for the Essendon Football Club is?
Yeah, amazing again.
Yeah, pretty remarkable.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Good. All right. Cordial first or water? Tell me you don't drink cordial.
No, I like that.
Ah, good.
I don't drink it a lot, but I like it.
Yeah?
Cordial first. Yeah.
Cordial first?
Yeah, cordial first.
Cordial first, all right. What's better, mark or goal of the year?
Goal.
Goal?
Yeah, goal.
Goal. Oh, wow. Is that because you boys don't?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Stay on the ground.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, we're not that tall.
Who's your Brownlow chip for 2021?
I think Bontempelli. The way he's been playing the last few weeks.
Yep, good. Nice.
I'll say Zach Merritt.
Good. Beautiful. Essendon Football Club at the end of the home and away season this year will finish?
Eighth,
okay.
Yeah.
That's not right. All right. Who is your favourite football commentator, if you have one? You can pass on that too if you want.
Yeah, pass.
Yeah. Does?
Yeah,
pass. Yeah, all right, good. Should Tasmania have a team of their own?
Yeah, I think so. Eventually. Okay.
Yeah, good. Yeah, you could send.
Not fast either way, but.
Yeah, you could set a team down there. Mm.
Yeah, okay. Do you prefer to see the coach on the bench or in the box?
I like him on the bench.
Yeah.
To be honest, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, bench has been good so far. Yeah, enjoying it.
Good. Which end of the dim sim do you eat first? Well, there's the round end and then there's the cross end.
The cross end. Okay.
You go the cross end first.
Yeah.
I kind of like changing it up.
Like two, sometimes that.
Yeah.
Flip it over.
Yeah, if you buy two, have one way, one the other. Yeah.
Cool. Soy sauce? Soy sauce for both of you?
Yeah.
All right. So riveting questions here. Don't worry about that. We ask them all. We ask the hard stuff. Who does the hair the most at the club?
Yeah, his doesn't move. Dylan, David. Him. Langers, Draper.
Snelling. Wow.
Snelling.
Jeez, it must be all fighting over the mirror.
Ridley, there's a lot of them.
Okay, all right. Well, let's go with that then. Who is the most famous person you have in your phone and have you ever rung them?
Probably Pidge is my most famous.
Okay.
And yes, I have rang him very a couple of times.
I like it.
I don't know.
No?
Oh, maybe Dyson. But yeah. Chris Jard, maybe.
Okay, that'll do. Good answers. If you had to choose just one, radio or TV, which would you choose?
TV.
TV.
Yeah, probably TV as well.
Okay, all right. Only a couple more to go. Sauce, does it go in the cupboard or the fridge?
Fridge, mine is, I think, at the moment.
Yeah, the fridge.
Yeah, both of your fridge, yeah. All right. What do you think when you see a poster or merchandiser of yourself?
Yeah, it's pretty weird.
Yeah, weird. Just pretty weird? All right. And here's your last one. What is your reaction when you see a kid with your number on their back?
I love that. It's one of the best parts about playing footy, I think.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, super special and
nice feeling.
Yeah, great feeling.
Yeah, beautiful. I love that too. Nice one to finish on. Put your hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks, boys. So easy. All right, just to finish up with a little bit of housekeeping, upcoming shows. I may have explained to you off the top, we're doing 28 shows out of the Mulgrave Country Club this year, which is fantastic. I'm so stoked to be coming here every week. It's a beautiful venue. It's like a crown casino in the suburbs. The food's great. The people are friendly. It's just a really nice environment. I'm sure you'll all agree. We've enjoyed you all coming along tonight. We're going to be doing, obviously, we've had 3 shows prior to this one. This is our 4th. So we're going to have 24 shows to go. Whew. Okay, so 4 down and 24 to go. So coming up next week, April the 7th, we've got from the Richmond Football Club, Richmond players Tom Lynch and Jaden Short. On April the 14th, we've got Western Bulldogs players Josh Dunkley and Adam Treloar. On April the 24th, we've got Carlton players Harry Mackay and Jack Silvani. All right, go easy. They're not here right now, so... and shows feature will feature players coming up from Collingwood, Hawthorne and Geelong. Yeah, so you can just stand out the front if you want and throw rocks at the cars when they turn up. All right. No, don't do that. I don't condone that at all. Now, as we're slowly finding our way back to a new post-COVID normal, whatever that is, please understand that tickets at this stage are only available through the That's Good Footy website. Don't ever buy them through secondhand. You always go through the That's Good Footy website. It's easy to do. Simply log on to www.thatsgoodforfooty.com.au/events or click on the links in the post on the That's Good for Footy page. This too will take you through to the ticketing platform. These shows are recorded in front of a live audience at the Mulgrave Country Club, which is located in Wheelers Hill, opposite the old VFL Park. If you'd like to be kept informed of when your club is going to be appearing next, simply get onto the Facebook page, like it, or go and sign up, and then you'll get a text message. How many of you got a text message saying that this show was on? Yep, good, okay. Well, more of you need to sign up so you can all get it, because that's what we want to do to keep you informed. But as I said, you can simply go through to the That's Good Footy Facebook page, do your signing up there. Now, can I please get you to put your hands together for Sam and Sandy? Sam, a sound engineer, Sandy does the door. Thank you, my dear. There's only 3 of us that do these shows. Everyone think there's a massive production crew that goes on behind the scenes. There's not. There's that beautiful man, Sam, and this lovely girl, Sandy, and me. That's it. So we always love it when you guys come along and appreciate our work that we do. Without those two, I couldn't do these shows. So cheers to both of you. Whilst we're at it, could you please keep the applause going for our 2 guests tonight? Andrew McGrath, Darcy Parrish. Thanks, boys. Great to have you along. Thanks for giving up your Wednesday night and coming here. How'd you go? You haven't been on the shows for a little while. We didn't do anything last year, so what's it like being back?
Nah, great fun. Oh, I really enjoyed myself, so...
Yeah, good.
Awesome.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun. Obviously need to learn a bit more about movies before my time, but it was great seeing all you guys, and hopefully we can get a win for you this weekend.
Well done. Well said. Well said. Thank you very much. Okay, well, that's it. This has been the That's Good for Footy panel show. My name is Damien. Thanks, everyone, for coming along tonight. Thank you and good night. Cheers, guys.